Hi, I'm Dean Perrine, Executive Vice President at JSA, and I'm here with Monique Lanne-Petit. Monique is the Director of Telecom Sans Frontières. Monique, thanks for joining us.
Thank you very much, Dean.
You got it. So can you give us an update on what TSF has done most recently during the pandemic?
As you know, TSF is a humanitarian NGO focused on emergency response technologies. Our mission is to reconnect vulnerable population in a wide range of humanitarian crises. At the beginning of the pandemic, we started our response by mobilizing the contact we developed during over 20 years of humanitarian operations on the ground. We contacted local, national authorities in different countries to better understand their needs. And we participate as a partner in the United Nations mechanism put in place to respond to COVID-19. This helps us to monitor the situation as closely as possible and provide our support if needed. Following this conversation, we responded to the request of the Mozambican National Institute for Disaster Management. We provided satellite equipment, bandwidth, and remote training in order to support the coordination of their COVID-19 response operations, in particular in remote areas with no connections. This action has been facilitated by the satellite equipment donated by PCCW Global last year in the aftermath of Cyclone Idai. Today, we are continuing all of this conversation to monitor the needs and ensure a rapid response when needed. In parallel, we have adapted our existing project to the pandemic and its related restrictions. The technical solution we use allows us to manage all our action remotely and continue our assistance independently to the evolution of the pandemic. For example, we put in place remote activity in for children in Madagascar and remote learning for Syrian refugees children in Turkey. That will continue for as long as restrictions are in place in both countries. In Syria, we have adapted the number of vital connections in support of medical team on the ground. This is also the case in Bosnia and Herzegovina, where we are allowing immigrants to remain in contact with the families. Finally, in Mexico, where we provide to migrants vital information and protection measure and administrative procedure, we have adapted the content diffused to include up-to-date information on COVID, and we also increased the number of shelter in which we are present. We keep working to see how the project could be, this project could be further expanded.
I love it, Monique. Thank you very much.